So many of us take vitamins to stay healthy. The best recipe, though, could be right in your own fridge. And our fitness expert, Matt Hickey of Core Fitness Studio, is here with the five foods that will help boost our immunity, keep us healthy. Thanks for being here.
Thank you for having me.
All right, let's start out with the fruits.
Okay.
You've got some good ones out here.
Absolutely. So in spring, we have a lot of berries that come out, and fruits have a lot of vitamin C. Vitamin C helps boost our immune system, also helps shorten the duration of the common cold.
Okay, so get the blackberries, the raspberries, blueberries.
Strawberries, pineapple are out, tangerines, a lot of those are out, and they're really healthy for you.
Okay, the next one, vegetables. Which ones do you like?
Well, I like all vegetables, okay? Specifically, I love peppers, and the reason vegetables are great for you, they have a lot of fiber in them. And fiber helps promote a healthy digestive tract, and a healthy digestive tract leads to a healthy immune system.
And they always say look for colors, right?
Absolutely. The more color you have, the more nutrients you're going to have in them.
Okay, so you'd bought some bell peppers of every color of the
absolutely,
rainbow.
Absolutely, some artichoke, yep.
Okay, the next one are greens.
Yeah, and the key here is they contain a trace mineral called zinc. And zinc is found in a lot of over-the-counter cold remedies. So it helps boost your immune system. Yeah, and it also has healing properties for wounds.
Okay, do you like it cooked or raw in salads? What do you like?
I like it in salads. That's typically how I do it. You'll get more nutrients that way as well.
Okay, by keeping it raw?
By keeping it raw.
Okay, next up, grains. And we hear so much about whole grains and how good they are for
us. Whole grains, of course, the fiber part of it as well. One specifically that I like is called quinoa.
Okay.
And it has a lot of protein in it. Protein will help renew your body, especially after a cold or the flu. And those there actually have about double the amount of protein as regular whole grains.
Okay, quinoa with a Q, right?
With a Q, that's
right. All right, comes in a box. And how do you cook it?
You cook it just like you would regular grains in water and, let it sit. It takes a little while.
Good little
tip.
But
it's great stuff.
All right, and the next herbs, which are great for summer because anybody can grow these at home.
That's right. And you can have them at home. They taste great. The compounds in the actual oils, though, have antioxidant properties. And they also have anti-aging properties, which anybody can do it.
Okay, so you brought basil and chives.
Basil and chives. And basil probably is the one that has the most compounds that help with the antioxidant properties.
Okay. Well, that's easy one to get into. Pastas, any kind of dish out
Absolutely.
There.
Absolutely.
All right, well, thank you. We're going to get the fruits and the veggies and the greens and the grains all in our diets.
That's right.
Now.
And just make sure you choose local farmers. You're going to get a lot more nutrients out of it and organic when you can.
Okay, well, thanks for sharing the foods that give us the most bang for our buck. We
You're
appreciate
welcome.
It, Matt. Thank you. We want to let you know that our call forward lines are open right now and staffed with human resource experts to help you get a job. Here's the number to call.